Ankyloglossia, symptoms, and treatment. Ankyloglossia, commonly referred to as tongue tie, is a condition that affects many individuals from infancy through adulthood. This condition can lead to several challenges, impacting various aspects of daily life, including feeding and speech. Here, we delve into the details of ankyloglossia, providing insights into its symptoms, causes, diagnosis, treatment options, and management strategies. What is ankyloglossia? Ankyloglossia is a congenital condition characterized by a short and tight lingual frenulum, which limits the movement of the tongue. This restriction can significantly affect several vital functions such as breastfeeding, eating, and speaking. While some individuals may find their tongue mobility sufficient, others may struggle with various tasks due to the limitations imposed by the frenulum. The condition varies in severity, with some individuals experiencing few or no issues, while others may face significant challenges. It's essential to understand that ankyloglossia can lead to complications if left unaddressed, especially in infants. The prevalence of ankyloglossia is higher in males, and while genetic factors are believed to contribute to its occurrence, the exact cause remains largely unclear. Understanding this condition is crucial for parents and healthcare providers, ensuring that those affected receive the appropriate care and support. What are the symptoms of ankyloglossia? The symptoms of ankyloglossia can vary widely among individuals. Some common symptoms include difficulty in lifting the tongue. This can hinder activities such as eating, speaking, and oral hygiene. Notched appearance of the tongue. When extended, the tongue may appear notched or heart-shaped. Challenges with breastfeeding. Infants may struggle to latch properly, which can lead to frustrating feeding experiences. Speech difficulties. Some children may develop speech disorders due to restricted tongue movement, impacting articulation. Dental issues. Ankyloglossia can contribute to problems with tooth alignment and oral hygiene. Parents or caregivers should be vigilant for these signs, as early identification can facilitate timely intervention, improving outcomes for affected individuals. What causes ankyloglossia? The exact causes of ankyloglossia are still a subject of research, but several factors may contribute to its development. Genetic predisposition, family history may play a role, suggesting a hereditary component to the condition. Developmental issues, ankyloglossia may arise during fetal development, resulting in an unusually short frenulum. Environmental influences, although less understood, certain environmental factors during pregnancy could potentially impact tongue development. Ankyloglossia is not always associated with other conditions, but it is beneficial to evaluate the overall health and development of infants displaying symptoms, as other congenital anomalies may sometimes coexist. How is ankyloglossia diagnosed? Diagnosing ankyloglossia typically involves a physical examination by a healthcare provider who will assess the structure and function of the tongue. Key aspects of diagnosis include visual examination. The medical professional will check the tongue's range of motion, appearance, and frenulum length. Feeding assessment. In infants, observing breastfeeding or bottle feeding can provide valuable insights into potential challenges. Speech evaluation. For older children or adults, speech assessments may help determine if ankyloglossia is impacting communication. It's crucial for healthcare providers to consider the individual's age and developmental stage when diagnosing ankyloglossia, as symptoms and management strategies may differ. What are the treatment options for ankyloglossia? Treatment for ankyloglossia depends on the severity of the condition and the specific symptoms experienced by the individual. Possible treatment options include observation. In mild cases, healthcare providers may recommend monitoring the situation without immediate intervention. Speech therapy. Speech-language pathologists can assist in addressing articulation issues resulting from restricted tongue movement. surgical options, for significant challenges, procedures such as frenotomy or frenuloplasty may be recommended to release the frenulum. Parents are encouraged to consult with healthcare providers to determine the most appropriate course of action tailored to the individual's needs. What complications can arise from ankyloglossia? Ankyloglossia can lead to several complications if not addressed. Some of these may include breastfeeding difficulties. Infants with ankyloglossia may struggle to latch effectively, leading to inadequate nutrition and potential weight loss. Speech disorders. Children may experience challenges in articulation, affecting their ability to communicate effectively. Dental issues. The restricted tongue movement can contribute to poor oral hygiene and alignment problems with teeth. Recognizing these potential complications early can enable timely interventions, ensuring better outcomes for those affected. How is ankyloglossia managed in infants? Managing ankyloglossia in infants often involves collaborative efforts between parents, lactation consultants, and healthcare providers. Key strategies include lactation support. Consulting with lactation experts can assist in developing effective feeding techniques for infants with ankyloglossia. Monitoring growth. Regular checkups can help ensure that the infant is gaining weight appropriately and is thriving. Assessing the need for intervention. Parents should stay informed about their child's progress and consult with healthcare providers regarding potential treatment options. Taking a proactive approach to managing ankyloglossia can significantly enhance the infant's feeding experiences and overall development.